When I don't have art supplies nearby, I paint digitally. So this has become one of my favorite. So I'm just going to explain how I did this. So all these brush details are mentioned in the end of the video. You can take the screenshot and you can try it. If you're using some other apps, you can find out a way. It's available on all the apps. So better view, expand the screen and start working on it. If you are new to my channel, please watch other videos, and if you like it, please subscribe and support me to reach other beginners. So this is specially for beginners. I have already shared few videos on digital thing, so maybe in upcoming days I will come up with more videos. So do watch this video. Thank you. I'm using Autodesk sketchbook here. You can use any other apps. The basics are very same. So I started with adding green background in first layer, and then I started adding some other similar colors of blue or green, which looks like underwater, by using color builder, and I started smudging them a little bit. Smudge brushes are available. You can choose any of your comfortable smudging brush. Do not smudge completely, leave a little bit of texture here and there, and try to make it like underwater. Just adjust and all. You can change the brush size and all. So go for it. When you are satisfied, then stop right there and use other layer, because if you ruin something, then it is very difficult for you to correct it, and this app sucks actually. This texture looks like a light and shadow play in underwater. So far so good. Let's go for fishing now. On the extra layer, use technical pen or pencil, which is your comfortable. So draw some fish design. You can choose to draw anything. Just make sure you can fill that. So simple drawing. I better suggest you to draw yourself, not to trace, because it stops you from drawing skills. Improving drawing skills is also important when you draw. So just draw something and fill it with white and lock the layer. So better, I duplicate the layer, because if I ruin this one, then I can use the old one only. So you can choose to have a single one, or you can keep a backup. So just lock the layer and start filling that. Oh, this has become floppy fish. I purposefully did that so that I can show another content, that is transform option. So let's do that. So I chose to paint koi fish, which is good actually, good luck sign. And I just merged it here and there, and I just created highlights and shadow, all those things, by using the same color. For filling, I used the same brush, and for smudging also one of smudge brushes. So all these colors I used, and I went to transform, and this is how transform works. The first option helps you to change your object. You can drag it and create some other shapes as well. So now little less fluffy fish it happened. So go concentrate on drawing. I'm just explaining, that's why I'm not concentrating. So when you're painting it in details, just make sure the outlines are very perfect. So far so good. I created another duplicate layer, and I'll hide this other layer. Once the basic step is over, you can create some other details later as well. So it's good to go with the duplicate layer so that you have a backup plan for your mess. To create textures, you can go for some other brush. I love using tattoo inker from Basic, or you can go for basics as well. Shapes as well. I use tattoo inker to create tails. This one I created in next layer, and I'm not locking the screen, and I just smudged it to create some moving kind of thing. And by using smudge brush only, you can create some details. And now the screen is not locked, the layer is not locked, so that you can recreate the shapes as you want. For detail smudging, I use just wedge smudging brush. You can choose any of the smudge brushes which are comfortable for you. Using the tattoo inker, I'll be creating eyes. I'm using other layer, and I will lock the layer, and I will create details. What we need next is green shades to make it look like underwater. So what I'm going to use is, I'm going to use Bristol brush, and I will be adding very light layer of green here and there to make it a shadow. For bubble kind of look, I'll be using similar colors inside the water, and we'll be adding some drops here and there. That is in the shapes actually. You can use anything. You can smudge them as well if you want, a little bit as a shape. Digital painting requires a lot of patience, so be careful when you do it. To improve your digital painting skills, I suggest you not to go for tracing work or any smudging works. Draw yourself and create some poster kind of thing yourself. Practice always helps you to create something more amazing, and you will get amazed by your own work. That is what important. More details you add, more the file size becomes, and more larger printouts you can take from it. This is what I created with patience. So I hope I explained in an easy way. So I'll be coming up with more detailed works again, and you can use any other apps as well and create something more amazing and share it with me, so that I can feature those things on my YouTube channel, and let's go together. Thank you so much for watching.